Ever since the Vega sphere was revealed, I was amazed by the engineering involved in it. It's like this mathematical wonder made from millions of LEDs, which honestly looks like CGI. I haven't had the chance to see it in real life because I live so far away, but what I want to do is build a baseball-sized version of it that can live on my desk. This is not going to be easy because we need to fit as many LEDs as physically possible, have them be equally spaced, and also figure out how to create this spherical look. One way of doing this is by spinning a ring of LEDs with a motor. This can get quite a good resolution, but there's a few disadvantages about it. The second option is to use a flexible circuit. The idea here is to have some kind of 2D shape that could wrap around a plastic mount to form the hemisphere. I used a similar approach a few years ago for this LED ping pong ball build. That one only had 242 LEDs, and they weren't equally spaced, which lost a bit of the magic. I think this idea could better represent the technology used in the Las Vegas sphere, because obviously that building doesn't have any motors spinning LEDs around. So next, I had to figure out a two-dimensional shape that could be folded into a sphere while still keeping equally spaced pixels. Making models out of paper helped me understand which shape could work best with flexible circuits. So far, this one is the roundest, but it's going to be impossible to align the LEDs because the edges are curved. The best option was to construct the sphere from tiny triangles. This is what's called a geodesic sphere, and it's the math behind every spherical building around the world. The larger the sphere is, the more triangles you need, but mine was only going to be 6 centimeters diameter, so I was using what's called a V3 model, which is like the basic level. So with the help of these online calculators, I found the dimensions of my model, imported a DXF file into Altium Designer, and then divided the outline into other tiny triangles to fit the LEDs. The way I tackled this complex PCB design is by dividing the geodome into 5 pieces. So I only routed one piece and then inserted the same design 5 times into a panel. This was a bit risky because all the nets disappear. So if there's a short out, you won't see it, but it saved me a lot of time. The LEDs I'm using here are the smallest addressable LEDs, and in total I managed to fit 945. I also had to turn this into a 4-layer flexible board so that I could add power planes and decoupling capacitors to reduce noise. Remember, if you'd like to try Altium Designer, there's a link for it in the description, where you can also get 25% off. Unfortunately, this first PCB I received had some issues. There was a short which I did not catch in my panel design, and it was inside one of the inner layers, so I couldn't fix it and test out the board. This also meant that the assembly could not be tested, and some LEDs had some soldering issues. The adhesive on the backside was also wet from the alcohol cleaning, which was unmountable. But together with PCBWay's help, we resolved these issues, and they managed to sponsor 5 fresh new boards. Next, I connected the board to my favorite controller, and this time all of the 945 LEDs were blinking red, green, and blue. The brightness of the LEDs was just set to 10% power so that I could power it from the USB-C port. The next step was the scariest because I had to peel the tape cover, align and mount it to the 3D printed base. It had some edges that didn't stick too well to the base, and the pixels were a little too bright to look at, but adding a white 3D printed diffuser brought a nicer effect. Some of the seams are visible through the diffuser, but I don't think there's a way to hide them further. While I was writing some code to create new patterns on the display, I accidentally ripped off the flexible cable. This was an unfixable mistake because the tracks were inside the inner layers. I modified the mechanical design to prevent this from happening again, but I had to start again with a new board. And this one was a disaster to mount. And it wasn't just this one, the same thing happened with another new board. One of the things we noticed is that the tape had become less sticky over time. And most probably this was happening because of the temperature and humidity in my workshop. So for the 4th attempt, I dried out the boards before mounting them. And this made a huge difference because all the pixels were now curved the right way. There was a little bump over here at the point where the cable enters inside, but with the diffuser it still didn't look that bad. So the next step was to discover what this thing can show, and the simplest way was to start with patterns. To show some of these animations, I had to figure out how to take a low resolution image and map it to the sphere. With the same method, I managed to create a blinking eye, which didn't look too bad. However, the effect starts to get lost when you shift the eyeball, because the circular iris cannot keep its shape. The main problem here has to do with the resolution. We almost have 1000 pixels, which may seem a lot, but the radius is still small, non-linear, and still not very dense. So the size struggles to show like basic text, the planet Earth, Pokemon balls, and fish. But I did manage to animate the iconic sphere emoji character. It started by looking like a creepy emoji, but eventually I evolved it into something friendly. When you pick it up, it gets scared, and shaking it makes it vomit. Now, the biggest problem with this technology is that each individual LED costs around 5 cents, which brings the total cost of all the LEDs to around $50. And this is still not including the PCB, the soldering, the controller, and the mechanical assembly. So I think the price of this thing, considering what it can display, is out of proportion. Going to a bigger size would improve the resolution because you have denser pixels, but it would also come at an even higher price. So I'm not completely sure if this idea is worth pursuing further. Do let me know what you think in the comments down below, and if you enjoyed this build, please consider subscribing and liking this video. Huge thank you to all my Patreons for supporting my work.